Hello there, I'm Josh Modifile Heaven, and today we are doing a review on the Hifiman Ananda Bluetooth. This is a Bluetooth headset, but pretty different from most Bluetooth headphones. Those are open back Bluetooth headphones, so this is going to be interesting. Also, those are very expensive. They are about $1,000, so this is a high-end Bluetooth headphone. This is interesting, actually, because you can expect I listen to them before doing the little unboxing video and such, but they are very, very, very interesting. So they come basically in a large package in which you find the carrying case. This is how it looks. This is the Hifiman carrying case. It is very nice. I think this is one of the nicest carrying cases I have seen for a headphone. As far as I understand, the original Ananda also comes with the same carrying case. Good job for the guys at Hifiman. So, inside the case you can find the headphones, the Ananda Bluetooth. As you can see, they are very well made. The headband is probably, I think, the same as the one on the Hifiman EH6SA and the same on the Hifiman Sundara. It is the same headband and the same cup mechanism, but the ear cups are different. Those are the Aria-shaped cups. They are very comfortable, very large. Inside the package, you can also find a little charging / data cable, this one, and a little microphone thing, which I think looks a bit kinky when you put it in action. I don't expect many people to be using this headphone as a Bluetooth headset for phone calls. Anyways, those are the headphones. The Hifiman Ananda Bluetooth supports every single kind of Bluetooth exotic protocol, so you can expect to connect them to every single smartphone, player, anything. They support absolutely everything. It is also written on the back of the box, all of the protocols they support. So yeah, you expect to have APTH, APTX HD, LDAC, and all the crazy stuff. You can use the Hifiman Ananda Bluetooth to watch movies. You can use them to play games because they have very low latency. They have the APTX low latency, so pretty much everything you could desire from them. The Hifiman states battery life of about 10 hours, but I was able to get about 7 out of them, somewhere in that ballpark. You probably will not get the full 10 hours of battery life out of them. They charge pretty fast. I don't think I waited too much for them to charge, so that is a plus. You don't have to worry about charging them. They are very comfortable, as you can see here. Very comfortable, very large. They will work with every single ear shape. You won't have any kind of issue wearing them. About the price, they are really worth the price for the money, and this is the fun part. This actually has both enough volume, like they get loud enough, and has the sound quality of a proper, properly amplified Bluetooth Ananda. So basically, this is like a very well amplified Ananda, like an Ananda amplified from, I don't know, an Ibiso DX220. So basically, this is like a really expensive setup, but in Bluetooth, so you won't have to worry about the cables. So I don't know, I think this is a very happy purchase for anyone who is interested in a nice Bluetooth headphone. The controls are pretty forward, except for the fact that here the round button here is a charging button. You need to press it for them to start charging. If you don't press it, they will not charge. So that is a bit inconvenient, I would call it. But the ear cups are soft. This is the Hifiman quality, which is very good nowadays. I will say this, the Hifiman quality has improved a lot over the years, and they are not having issues anymore. I know that some people ping me sometimes and ask me whether they should purchase or not a Hifiman headphone, because they have heard that Hifiman has iffy build quality, but I don't think that is the case anymore. I think that Hifiman has a very good build quality, very good construction, very good reliability. I have been using the same pair of Sundara for they are somewhere in that area, this is why I'm looking at them. So I've been using the same pair of Sundara for at least 1 year in both winter, dust, and storms. I even went with my Sundara through rain and they are still alive, so I think that Hefiman is doing a great job on build quality nowadays. I know that some people have experienced some issues with their build quality, but I'm just saying nowadays that shouldn't be an issue anymore. Anyways, they are also great with warranty. If an issue is to arise, they will solve it really quickly. They will give you instructions to send the product back and it will be solved very quickly. So no worries about that. The sound of the Ananda Bluetooth is pretty much the same as the natural Ananda. I have had the chance to hear an Ananda. It is a very open kind of sound, very wide soundstage, very airy, but also has a very nice bass. I would call it slightly V-shaped, so the bass and the treble are slightly emphasized compared to the mid-range, but I don't know, that's not exactly the case. They're very natural sounding, very musical. It is one of my favorite $1,000 headphones, I will be honest with you. They sound really, really good. Very, very excellent dynamics, very punchy sound, very large soundstage, wide. I don't know. They have pretty much everything you could ask from a Bluetooth headphone. Or from a headphone at $1,000. If I am to compare them to, I don't know, LCD2 from Audies, those are much more natural sounding. The LCD2 is very thick. Those aren't as thick. Those are much more natural, much more airy, much more wide in the soundstage. Much better definition for instruments. I don't know. This is a really good headphone. They are not very heavy. I don't know, Hefiman quotes about 500 grams for them, which would be a bit much for a headphone, but they really do not feel heavy. They feel as light as, not as light as Aria. You can feel that they are heavier than Aria or the original Ananda, but they are light. I mean, I wouldn't bother. The weight doesn't bother me, the weight of the headphone. So overall, I think this is a very good purchase. This is like a proper flagship Bluetooth headphone. I reviewed a few and I have heard a few, and most Bluetooth headphones either fail in not delivering enough volume, so most of them don't get loud enough, or they fail in other areas. Those don't fail in any area. They have very good signal coverage, very strong sound, and they have the quality of the original Hefiman Ananda. So basically, this is a full-sized setup for $1,000, a setup that would normally cost about $2,000. So yeah, very, very nice job from the guys at Hefiman. I thank you for watching. I hope you'll consider subscribing to my YouTube channel and watch my other videos about audio products. I hope you have a lovely week in there and I hope to see you soon. Bye bye.